Stand up and praise the Lord if you can. If you want to sit down and praise the Lord, you can. If you're like running around acting silly, you can. You can do, just feel free to praise the Lord this morning. That's what we're here to do this morning. Amen.
Oh, Lord, oh, Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh, Lord, we praise your name. Oh, Lord, we magnify your name. Prince of Peace, mighty God. Oh, Lord God Almighty.
Amen. Praise him this morning.
Oh, Lord. Majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Oh Lord, we praise your name. Oh Lord, we magnify your name. Prince of Peace, mighty God. Oh Lord. Magnify the Lord.
Let's magnify the Lord.
He is worthy to be praised. And oh, magnify the Lord.
I will magnify you.
For he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna.
Jesus.
Jesus, you're the rock. Jesus, you're the rock of my salvation.
Amen. Can you praise him this morning and say hallelujah? Amen.
And oh, magnify the Lord. Is worthy to be praised.
Are worthy to be praised.
And oh, magnify the Lord.
Let's magnify the Lord.
For he is worthy to be praised. Hosanna, blessed be the rock. Blessed be the rock of my salvation. Hosanna. Jesus, you're the rock. Jesus, you're the rock of my salvation.
Amen, 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 amen. You know, I want y'all to be comfortable in here. I know this is a different kind of music than what we usually start with. So you just have fun with it. And if you don't feel like singing, you can stand back there and just listen. But, you know, I had a preacher that was a missionary I met at Home Depot yesterday. 30 years in the mission field in Mexico. And I told him, I said, you know, we do praise and worship. We do old songs as well. He said, do you really get anything out of those newer songs? And I said, yes, sir. I said, if you really come to praise and worship the Lord, the words in those songs will change your heart.
Amen. Amen.
And he said, you know, I may have to visit your church.
Amen.
Him and his wife. And I didn't know he's a missionary until yesterday. He said, there's something different about you in this paint booth. I said, well, I've been here 27 years. I said, I must like it. I said, I do like to talk to people.
Amen.
And you know what? We can all change. And there is a message in these songs. The repetitiveness gets it in your spirit. I heard people say it's a 7-Eleven song. You sing it 11 times or something till you get it or whatever. I don't know what it means, but anyway. These are words right out of the Bible.
Amen.
and they'll speak to your heart.
Amen.
So sing with us.
And Lord, I lift your name on high.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
And Lord, I love to sing your praises.
Lord, I love to sing your praises.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
I'm so glad you came to save
you
us.
You came to save us.
And you came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. And Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises.
Lord, I love to sing your praises.
And I'm so glad you're in my life.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
And I'm so glad you came to save us. 'Cause you came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. And Lord, I lift your name on high. And Lord, I lift your name on high.
Amen. Now, if you want to, you can get 772 in that hymnal. That's when we all get to heaven. We're going to sing that right now.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansion, bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout for victory.
Okay, hold on just a second. We need a polka beat on this. We need this to be going pop, 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 pop.
Hold on,
okay?
We need to change chords.
What's the next verse, baby? I don't have my... There we go. All right, goes. There you go.
And while we walk the pilgrim pathway, clouds will overspread the sky. But when traveling, days are over, not a shadow, not a sigh. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. The pearly gates will open. We shall tread the streets of gold. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout for victory.
Open with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the excitement that we can have in Christ Jesus our Lord. Father, life doesn't have to be bland and mundane. Father, we worship with all our energy, But Father, you're worthy. You're worthy of all the praise and adoration that goes with the kingdom of God. So Father, bless us in this time of worship together. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. William, come on up here. William's got an announcement. We have a seminar coming up. And if you got an insert there. It's kind of ominous when you first look at it. Surviving a shooting. But unfortunately, this is something that churches, schools, malls, restaurants all have to think about nowadays. So William, share with us what's going on.
I guess about 2 years ago, you and I attended a
Crockett,
a seminar regarding church security and stuff. So I invited the pastor to a gun law seminar a couple weeks ago, and it's really a Lord thing because when we're talking, the director or the regional director of the U.S. Law Shield mentioned that they put on active shooter seminars for churches. So we've been wanting to do this for a couple years. So this seminar is going to be for our church specifically in regards to the security setup, where our weaknesses are, what to do if an active shooter occurs in the church, what you're to do. These guys are going to come with some of those answers. And we're going to have an attorney there. Retired HPD homicide is going to be there, which I've known him for a long time. So they're going to look our system over. They're going to look how we do things, maybe make some changes that we need. And legally, we're going to learn some things, liabilities to the church as a whole, to individuals. So there, I want y'all to kind of think of some questions so when these guys get here, we can address them. It's going to be from 6 p.m., June the 3rd, 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. So put that on your calendars and let's show up.
And we'll have a little break in between.
Yeah, around 7:30.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll go to the fellowship and have some drinks and stuff. So
we got to mention the food part to get the Baptist here.
I think it's going to be a good program.
It will be good. We need to know. It's a changing environment out there, folks, and we need to be aware of what's going on. So I hope you can plan to attend. Invite other churches, pastors especially, to come and be a part of that as well. Be on Monday night.
Monday night.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, William. Anybody else have any announcements to make? Come on up here, lady.
Okay, was the GA girls, well, mostly me, because we canceled church Wednesday night, didn't get to finish the cups. But I have the cups finished, and we're raising money to get their shirts. And they're in the back, they're $5. Some say Happy Mother's Day, some that does not. And we'll also gather up. I've talked to two different missions, the Church Under the Bridge. Tyler, they're needing shopping bags. And I met a lady in Lufkin that's also doing the shopping bags into a mat. So anybody has any Walmart shopping bags, any of those, I need them to send them to them. And also the person, the church, the lady, she's also the judge of Isabella, I can't think of her name. She does the every Sunday at 10 o'clock in the park, they do a hot meal for the homeless. 10:30, they have a little service. And she's going to start giving me a list. They're in desperate need of men's socks, women's personal items, and toothbrushes, toothpaste, any hygiene for men. Strictly, they serve 20 to 50 people every Sunday morning, and they are the ones that are literally living on the street. That some of them will not go to the shelters.
Yeah.
So they're in need of, right now, desperate need of men's socks. So I'll be taking notes to the Valla. She's going to give me a list every 2 weeks, and I'm going to start delivering them to the City Hall in Savala. So the girls will be, not me.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
Y'all.
Thank you, Lisa. Appreciate that. Anyone else have any announcements? Yes. Amen. Amen. Mow the grass.
Mow the grass.
Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. Okay. These flowers were donated by the Wendell family for Mother's Day. Beautiful flowers. We appreciate that. And want to be in prayer for them during this time of loss in their life. Just keep, hold them close to you in your prayers. And also, we want to be in prayer for upcoming events this summer. We've got a lot of things going on. And school lets out in how many weeks, young people?
2 weeks.
They know. They know, don't they? Tammy probably knows the hours. But yeah, I mean, school's almost out. Then our summer program kicks in, so we're excited about all that. And anybody else have any other announcements? Yes. Mother's Day. When you leave here, ladies, there's going to be some women standing in the back foyer back there handing out Mother's Day gifts. It's a tape measure, so your husband can measure his fish. Because I heard that somebody got in trouble having fish that were not long enough or something. But yeah, now these are wonderful gifts that the ladies have put together for you, and so please receive one as you're going out. Anybody else? Well, if anybody here had a birthday or anniversary, any birthdays or anniversary? Well, I know that Tony's folks had 65 years, right? Alan, Cindy's, all their mom and dad had 65-year wedding anniversary. Isn't that remarkable? That is a blessing right there. Anybody else? Nobody had a birthday anniversary. Well, Tony, let's do some more of this footwork.
This different kind of singing, huh?
Get after it.
Yeah. You know, hey, you know what? When I go see mom and dad after lunch, I want to say that y'all sang happy anniversary to them. So how about that? Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary, God bless you. Happy anniversary to you. Amen. And that'll bring a smile to their face just to know that you were thinking about them this morning. Also, in the future, we would love for you guys to fill this choir up. So if you like these kind of songs, and we're still going to be doing songs out of the book as well. Love to have you guys standing up here praise and worship with us. Be awesome. So feel free, anytime you get here, just walk on up here and sit down. Because we're not getting rid of a choir. We love the choir, okay? So come and sing with us, okay? 572.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. And oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit, and washed in His blood. And this is my story. My song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst on my sight. Angels descending, ring from above, echoes of my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. And perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed, watching and waiting, looking above, and filled with His goodness, and lost in His love. For this is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. And this is my story, and this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Amen. Amen. 7:05, I believe. It is well with my soul. When peace like a river attended my way, when sorrows like sea billows rose, And I lay my life before you. How I love you. Father, I adore you. Sing it to him. And I lay my life before you. How I love you. Jesus, I adore you. And I lay my life before you. Serve an awesome God, you know. You know, and I don't have a really wonderful Mother's Day song. They should write more Mother's Day songs. My sister gave me a song by B.J. Thomas. You know, it just didn't fit. Had some good words in it, but it just didn't fit. But this song here, you know, my mom and dad, so special to us kids, and I'm sure your mom and dad is too, and all the mothers that are out here right now. I'm trying to find my song here. But they're going through a hard time right now. Mama's nerves, her fear. It's got them chained. They don't feel like they're going to come back. And I wish Mom would have felt good enough to come this morning. I'm not ready to give up on them. And that the fear that they have, we know God can take care of that. So I'm going to find this song yet. You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. And I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. That's what we all got to say. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. And from my mother's womb, you have chosen me, and love has called my name. And I've been born again into a family. Your blood flows through my veins, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. You know, there might be something that's against you right now. God says, don't fear it, because I've got it. I've already taken care of it at the cross. All of us have fears, but we got to give it to him. I remember back when I had my depression, everybody said, just get over it. Just go on. Depression is real, but it does have a name, and Jesus is above all names.
Hallelujah.
And he wants to deliver us from all things. And I know he can deliver us. He can deliver you, whatever you're going through. And he can deliver my mom and dad.
Yes.
And I believe believe he will. He split the sea.
You split the sea so I could walk right through it. My fears were drowned in perfect love. And you rescued me so I can stand and sing. I am a child of God.
Y'all sing it with me. You split the sea.
You split the sea so I could walk right through it. And my fears were drowned in perfect love. And you rescued me so I could stand and sing. I am a child of God. And I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. And I'm no longer a slave to fear.
Yes, stand up.
I am a child of God, and I'm no longer a slave to fear.
Amen.
I am a child of God, and I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Thank you, Lord. You may be seated. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, guys. What a blessing that is. When I was growing up, I had a wonderful sister named Kathy. Jennifer, Matthew. What's said in this church stays in this church. Those are my great niece and great nephew there. I don't want them going home telling everybody what I said. Kathy and I grew up together. And as siblings, we get in arguments a lot and get some knockdown dragouts sometimes. We get to fussing at each other. And the argument always came to an end when she'd use the words, "Mama said." I mean, you can't add nothing to that. That was it. That's like, you know, almost up there with what God said. Mama said. Mama said this, Mama said that, and discussion come to an end. Point of order. Parliamentary procedure, whatever you want to call it. That was it. So I got to thinking about the things that Mama taught, and I'm sure your Mama did too. Some of the greatest prophets that we've had in our lives go by the name of Mama. And so I went to this passage in Jeremiah, a passage of scripture that I shared with Lauren last week when she was anticipating having to go in for surgery. And I told Lauren, I said, "Lauren, I want you to pray this scripture." And you know, it's okay to pray the scriptures. Have y'all ever tried that? That is a direct line to God right there, folks. You just go ahead and pray that scripture because you prophesy what comes out of your mouth. Your words carry a lot of weight. And so you prophesy good health and good strength and all that, and the Lord will deliver it to you. And so I gave her this passage of scripture I want to read for this morning. Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 14. "Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved, for you are my praise." Let's go to the Lord. Heavenly Father, I ask, Lord, that you'll be with us. This morning, Father, I thank you, Lord, that I can lift our hearts up and worship you and praise you with wonderful songs, Lord. And Father, let this be an ongoing tribute to our commitment to you, that we will always, in whatever way we can, enrich, improve, and just develop a worship service here that will draw all people to Christ Jesus our Lord. So, Father, be with us this morning. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Now, I could take you through Jeremiah chapter 17. We could talk a little bit about the nation of Judah falling away from God and this and that. But I want to bring it down to a more personal level. I could go on and talk about how the church, and for the most part, is kind of getting away from where God wants us to be. But I want to bring it back to a more personal level. I want to talk about us and our own personal faith in God. And one of the greatest lessons that Mama ever taught us growing up by introducing us to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is found right here in Jeremiah 17. Because in Jeremiah 17, you have a nation that has strayed away from God. Sin has entered the nation, the life of Judah. And this one man who is called Jeremiah, many of them know him as the weeping prophet. And why was he weeping? He wasn't weeping because of what God was doing. He was weeping because his nation had fallen so far away from God. I'm here to tell you right now, however far Judah has fallen away from God back then, America's a lot further away than that. We're a lot further away from God than what Judah was right there. And so Jeremiah, selected by God, even before he was born, God called him to be a prophet to the nation. And this man of God, who is known as the weeping prophet, prayed for his nation, but he understood some fundamental fact that each and every one of us need to know here this morning. That if there's going to be a change in this nation, it's got to start in this heart right here. It's got to start each and every one of our hearts that there's going to be a change in our nation. And so Jeremiah understood that the weight of this nation was going to be placed on his shoulders. So he started praying for his own redemption and his salvation. He wanted to make sure that he was right with God if he was going to be the man of God that God has called to lead out in this. The very first verse that you'll see in this chapter 17 says that the sin of Judah was written with a pen of iron, with the point of a diamond. It is engraved on the tablet of their heart. The sin. There was a sin problem there. Now, Mama probably taught each and every one of you that you had to be good growing up, that you had to share with other people growing up. I doubt if Mama ever taught you to be bad. You probably learned on your own. I know I did. We all do. Because we're born in a sinful nature. We're born in a broken world. People don't have to teach us to be bad. That just comes natural. But what Mama had to teach us was how to share, be loving and kind to other people. That's what she had to teach us. Judah had fallen away from God, gotten so far away from God that God says these sins are written in a pen of iron, a diamond engraved in this stone or this tablet in their hearts. That means it was there for good unless God did something. There's a permanent element about what that sin was. It was there for good unless God came and changed something. Praise God to Jesus Christ, Lord and Savior. He erased what the pen wrote in iron. He rubbed out diamond etched on the tablet. He got rid of that sin. And so the first thing we learned from Mama is that we got a sin problem. And this sin of Judah was so wicked and so terrible. In the end of verse 4, he says, the Lord says, "For you have kindled a fire in my anger, which shall burn forever." Now that's pretty serious stuff, isn't it? When God says something like that to you, you might want to rethink what you're doing. Because this is pretty serious stuff there. So the first thing we know is that we're going to need a healing. We're going to need some salvation if we're going to ever be where God wants us to be. There's a sin problem in our life, and unless we deal with it, it's going to be handed down to our children and our children's children. It's going to be something that will continue on if we don't show that there's a way out. Great thing about being a man of God, a woman of God, is that you teach your children not to make the same mistakes you made. You teach them that there's a better way in life. You go on, you read in the scriptures here, it tells us exactly. It says in verse 5, "Thus saith the Lord, curses a man who trusts in man and makes flesh his strength, whose heart departs from the Lord." What's so cursed about him? He says right there in verse 6, "For he shall be like the shrub in the desert. He shall not see when God comes, but shall inhabit the parched places in the wilderness, in the salt land, which is not inhabited." This is the man that has departed from God. But then, praise the Lord, God's redemptive power comes back in verse 17, and he says, blessed is the man. Now look at this. This is kind of the same message that Jesus taught in the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 5. He said, blessed is the man who trusts in the Lord, whose hope is in the Lord. It's one that trusts in the Lord that he's going to do what he says he's going to do right now, and a hope in the Lord that he's going to do what he says he's going to do in the future. Verse 7 is a salvation statement. Mama taught us about salvation, taught us that we need to trust the Lord. It says, trust the Lord, and whose hope is in the Lord, he's going to be like this, for he shall be like a tree planted by the water. Psalms tells us about that. Which spreads out its roots by the river, and listen to this, and will fear. I will not be a slave to fear, Tony. Not going to be a slave to fear. He will not fear when the heat comes, but its leaf will be green. He will not be anxious in the year of the drought, and he will cease, and he nor will he cease from yielding fruit. He's not going to fear. He's not going to be anxious, and he's going to keep on producing fruit. Praise God. This is what trusting in the Lord brings about. And so God is educating, God is enriching Jeremiah's life right here by telling him that you've got to trust in me, you've got to believe in me, you've got to place your hope in me. And as a nation, they were far away from that. Like I said, we're a lot further than they were. When all we hear is bickering and fighting and name-calling, all this stuff going on in our leadership, to act like a bunch of children. And it's time to put away childish things. Amen. It's time to put away childish things. That's what you do when you're a child. But now you're a man, you're an adult, you lead out. And this is what Jeremiah is learning from God. God comes back and tells Jeremiah, he says, the hearts are deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. I don't have to preach that to y'all. You want to know about wicked hearts? You want to know about deceitful things? Turn on television for a while. Look at the movies that are on the theaters that are on television right now. Number one selling movies are what? About demonic possessions and stuff like that? I mean, there's a lot that the devil has to offer in the world. There's a lot of wickedness out there. But the Lord says in verse 10, I, the Lord, search the heart and I test the mind. Why does he say that? Because he wants us to make sure that we have the mind of Christ and the heart of the Lord. That's what he's telling us there. Let me take you back to the passage of scripture we started with. This, I'll call it our mama's prayer. Jeremiah understood that there was a sin problem. Jeremiah understood that if they were going to get out from that sin problem, that he had to go to the Lord. The Lord is the only one to do it. And so Jeremiah here prays for deliverance. Just like the song says, heal me, O Lord, and I might be healed. I shall be healed. You got to claim that, folks. When you go to God and you pray for healing, whether it's a physical or mental or emotional or spiritual, whatever that healing you need, you claim that healing. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. I shall be healed. Save me, and I shall be saved. For eternity, I will be saved. And look what happens next. He comes to the Lord. He acknowledges that I got a sin problem. This nation's got a sin problem. By the way, don't think that you can't turn things around in this country of ours. You, as an individual, can start something all by yourself and turning a great nation around. Bible proves that many times. There's always one or two that were able to turn things around for the Lord. And so he says right here, heal me, O Lord, I shall be healed. Save me and I shall be saved. And then he comes back with, now that I understand that I can be healed, my sin is dealt with, that mark that was made with that pen is gone, that etched in was made with that point of the diamond is gone, I will praise your name. If you don't praise God for anything else, praise him for the fact that you don't have to live with your past anymore. Amen. Praise him for that. Praise him that you don't have to, you don't have to deal with this sin nature anymore, because Christ has taken away that sin and he cast it from as far as the east is from the west. Praise God for the fact that he died for our sins and we don't have to pay for them. I've been justified in my faith in Christ Jesus our Lord. Indeed, they say to me in verse 15, where is the word of the Lord? Let it come now. Y'all see what's happening here? These people are starting to turn around to Jeremiah's thinking, Jeremiah's leadership of the Holy Spirit. They're saying, Jeremiah, we understand what you're saying. We need to get things right. We need a revival to break out. We need a spiritual awakening to break out in our midst. We need to hear the word of the Lord. And then look where Jeremiah takes them. You read this for yourself. I'm not making this stuff up. It's in the scriptures. Jeremiah tells them, starting in verse 19, the first thing you need to do is honor the Sabbath. Oh, you got to find time to meet with others and worship the Lord. That's what he's telling us right there. You worship the Lord. You honor that Sabbath day. Hallow the Sabbath. He said, set time aside. Whenever that time may be, you set it aside to go and worship God. You take time out of your busy schedule. You find a place to worship God. Because if we're going to turn this nation back around, it's got to start with the family and with the church. That's where it's got to start. Want to worship God? You don't want to be a slave of fear. You're a child of God. Worship God like a child of God. Don't get lost. Don't get lost in the things of the world. Don't get lost on things that are going on around you. Go to the Word of God. Let me tell you something about this. This Word of God was given to us for a reason. If you have any questions about anything about God or Jesus Christ, go to the source. Go to the source. The internet might have a lot of things, but it's not the expert on the things of God. The Word of God is. Go to God. He gave you this work. He gave you this complete Word of God so that you could balance your life and live your life in abundance and freedom of Christ Jesus our Lord. Go to the Word, because the Word can make things right. We had the service yesterday from Big Mike, and one of the passages of Scripture I use a whole lot at the graveside comes from John 14. John 14, a wonderful passage of Scripture. Jesus is just about to go to the cross. He knows it. Some of the disciples, if not all of them, understood it. He told them that I'd have to die, but I would rise again. And so he's meeting with them kind of for one or two last moments. He tells them about the new commandment. He tells them about Peter going to deny him and all this and that. But then he gets to chapter 14. And he really just kind of takes away the anxiety and the fear. He says, let not your heart be troubled. Let me stop right there. You have control over whether or not your heart is troubled. Do with whether or not you believe in God or not. He says, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, what does that say? I will come again. Praise the Lord. I will come again. I will come again. What a magnificent word right there. And receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Don't leave here this morning without knowing Jesus Christ as the way, the truth, and the life. Let's stand together. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we set this day aside to honor our mothers. But Father, in honoring our mothers, we need to honor the message that our mothers left us with, or leaves us with, that you are sovereign God, as you deal with the problems that we have in life, that you can take away our fear and anxieties. Father, there's times that maybe we were laying in our beds as little children, disturbed by a nightmare or something that went bump in the night, and Mama would come in and say, everything's going to be all right. Jesus is with you. Jesus loves you. This I know, for the Bible tells me so. It was these simple messages from Mama in early life, Lord, that taught us, gave us the foundation for us to build a life to the point where we accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. And then, Father, we can look back after that point and we can see the wisdom and the knowledge that Mama left us with, that we can love one another, that we can live a life free of anxiety and pain and fears, that we are no longer slave to fear, Lord, that we can praise you with everything that's in us, Lord, because worthy is the Lamb to be praised. Worthy is the Lamb to be honored. So, Father, if there's any here that need to come forward and thank God for godly Mama, maybe now's the time to do it. Maybe we need to go to someone and pray with them, Lord. I want to thank you, Lord, for the miracles that we saw take place just in this last week, Lord, where your hand came down and changed things, altered things, Lord, for the good. You are an amazing God. And everything that's in us, we offer up to you in worship and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Why should we tarry when Jesus is pleading, pleading for you and for me? And why should we linger and heed not his mercies, mercies for you and for me? Come home, earnestly. the door. Go ahead, Doc.